Progressive groups questioning the decision of President Marcos to move the observance of Ninoy Aquino Day to August 23rd from its original August 21st schedule. Malacañang says the move aims to promote domestic tourism by providing Filipinos with a longer weekend, with the National Heroes Day to be observed on Monday, August 26th. Bayan Secretary General Renato Reyes accuses Marcos of trying to whitewash history. Albay Representative Ed Seligman also insisting Ninoy Aquino Day must be celebrated on the day of his assassination. Legman adding, no amount of holiday economics or domestic tourism can compare to Ninoy's heroism. The late senator's death triggered the 1986 People Power Revolution, which ousted the president's father, the late dictator, Ferdinand Marcos Sr. The province of Quezon mulls declaring a state of calamity if cases of African swine fever worsen. 7 out of the 40 municipalities in Quezon have reported ASF cases. For now, officials are urging hog raisers to maintain stricter security measures. On Thursday, the Agriculture Department announced the rollout of ASF vaccines could begin as early as next week, following the declaration of a state of calamity in some towns in Batangas due to the disease. Stonehenge, one of the most famous landmarks in the UK, has fascinated researchers for decades. Recent geological analysis has now revealed the remarkable journey of one of the sandstone slabs of the ancient wonder. More in this report.
A new discovery concerning Britain's famous Stonehenge monument has stunned researchers. Its altar stone, weighing an estimated 6 tons, travelled roughly 435 to 465 miles in ancient times, from Scotland all the way to England's Salisbury Plain. New research, published in the journal Nature, was carried out by scientists at Aberystwyth University, UCL, Curtin University, and the University of Adelaide.
However you brought it, whether you brought it down by boat, or whether you brought it overland, yeah, but it must have taken a huge effort to do that.
Nick Pearce is a geologist and co-author of the study.
And it sits right at the centre of the Stonehenge Monument. It's the bit that you stand on to watch the sunrise between the other stones over there. So it's right at the middle. So it must have been placed there as an important stone.
The origin and purpose of the altar stone have been among the mysteries of the megalithic monument. For the past century, the common belief had been that it had been sourced from Wales, like other large components at the UNESCO World Heritage Site. To find out the age of the stone, researchers studied its geochemical fingerprint.
It's a microanalysis technique. You fire a very focused laser beam on the minerals in the rock, and it vaporizes them. You analyze the vapor, and you analyze the uranium concentrations and the lead concentrations.
They found that the minerals of the altar stone are a perfect match for bedrock found in northeastern Scotland.
And you analyse 50 or 60 minerals, and you get this fingerprint of the different ages of those minerals in the rock, and that's the characteristic that tells us this is Orcadian Basin. It's that age, that suite of ages from those individual minerals in the grains in the altar stone.
No stone from any other monument dating back to that time period is known to have been transported so far. Researchers say this feat, perhaps by both land and sea, suggests a degree of societal organisation among Britain's Neolithic communities unexpected for the time when it was moved, thought to have been about 4,600 to 2,500 years ago. The precise location where the altar stone was sourced remains unknown. But researchers say the challenge of taking such a massive cargo such a long distance underscores its importance to Stonehenge's builders. The monument was built in multiple stages over 500 years or so, starting about 3000 BC. It remains a site of fascination and mystery over its exact purpose, drawing tourists from around the world.